Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of oil filter housing gasket failure. In this video, I'm primarily going to focus on BMW oil filter housings and oil filter housing gaskets, since this is a pretty common problem on a lot of different BMW engines specifically. The oil filter housing is a very simple component on the surface and does exactly what the name suggests. It houses the vehicle's engine oil filter, and on BMWs, this is typically located in the upper portion of the engine bay near the cylinder head, and the oil filter housing is sealed to the engine with a gasket. So ultimately that oil filter housing gasket is the failure and issue I'm going to be discussing mostly in this video. But one other thing to mention with the oil filter housing gasket on BMWs, while it is a very simple part on the surface, however, on most modern BMWs, it is a little bit more complicated since the oil filter housing also doubles as your oil cooler. And so ultimately that means that the oil filter housing actually needs channels for both oil and coolant to flow through. And then you have your oil cooler mounted on the other side of the oil filter housing, which ultimately means you have more gaskets and more seals that could potentially lead to failure, with it being a combination of the oil filter housing and oil filter cooler. So just wanted to mention that up front, since this oil filter housing design is a little bit more complicated in the sense that it doubles as an oil cooler and really a feed to that oil cooler. So with that out of the way, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common signs and symptoms of a leaking oil filter housing gasket. As a standard oil leak, this is really going to have a lot of the same symptoms as just about any other oil leak you could experience on a BMW or really any other engine for that matter. So a few of the most common signs and symptoms are going to be burning oil smells, a visible leak on the ground, or a visible leak coming from somewhere in the engine bay, and then low engine oil. So really not much to say there. Again, very common basic symptoms that you'll likely notice or experience with just about any oil leak. Now, a couple other extra symptoms include potential belt failure. The drive belt on BMWs located at the front of the engine is often right around the oil filter housing, as again, the oil filter housing is generally mounted near the top and generally forward in the engine bay. That means the oil filter housing on most BMWs lies directly above the drive belt. So if you do run into a leak from the oil filter housing gasket, it's very common for that to drop onto the drive belt, which can ultimately degrade the drive belt and cause premature failure. So if you run into a drive belt failure and start knocking out that repair, you might notice that you have some oil leak coming from the oil filter housing gasket, or you might notice that the belt looked wet or oily. And if that's the case, then definitely double check that oil filter housing gasket. The fifth and final symptom, we have oil and coolant mixing. So again, as I mentioned a little bit towards the start of the video, these oil filter housings on most modern BMWs double as not only the engine oil filter housing, but also as the oil cooler. So these oil filter housings do have both oil and coolant flowing through them. And so any gasket failure could potentially lead to oil and coolant mixing. This is, of course, a much more serious symptom and issue that could cause very serious engine damage if not caught in a timely manner. So just something to keep in mind if you suspect you have an oil filter housing gasket leak. It is very important on most of these modern BMW engines to get that addressed as soon as possible to ensure that you don't potentially have any engine, coolant, and oil mixing together. So really that wraps it up for all of these symptoms. Again, there are the few basic oil symptom leaks that you'll experience with just about any oil leak. Burning oil smells, visible leaks, low oil. On top of that, you might also notice oil mixing with the coolant, as well as belt failure if the oil has been dripping onto a drive belt for long enough. So with that out of the way, once you have identified the oil filter housing gasket as the cause of your oil leak, what does it look like for actually repairing and replacing a BMW oil filter housing gasket? So unfortunately, the oil filter housing gasket repairs can be pretty expensive on many of these modern BMW engines. A lot of the times they can be problematic enough that depending on the age and mileage of your vehicle, it might make sense to actually replace the entire oil filter housing rather than just the gaskets. That's what I've done on a couple of my BMWs and what I would highly recommend most others do, especially if you're past that roughly 8-year-old and 100,000 mile ballpark. It's a good idea to go ahead and replace that entire oil filter housing. Those parts generally run about $200 to $400 and you will be looking at about 3 to 5 hours of labor. So depending on what shop you go to and their hourly labor rates, generally another $300 to roughly $600 in labor. So that does bring it up to about a $500 to $1,000 repair job. So it is a little bit pricey. Again, you can save a little bit by just replacing the gaskets, but a lot of the times it makes sense to just go ahead and replace the complete oil filter housing. Now, one other thing I wanted to mention with repairs and replacement here is on a lot of these BMW engines like the N54, N55, N20, etc., it is going to require actually removing the intake manifold to replace the oil filter housing and gaskets. And so that's a great opportunity to go ahead and double check those intake valves and potentially walnut blast the intake valves, since carbon buildup is a common problem on many of these turbocharged direct injected BMW engines, and you're already paying for the labor for that intake manifold to come off. So if you find a shop that does intake valve cleaning or walnut blasting, this can be a great opportunity to save on labor and really kill two birds with one stone. So just something to consider if you find yourself in this boat and need to replace your oil filter housing or gasket. Don't forget about the intake valves and potentially getting those cleaned. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.